everyone. I'm here at Base Camp in Beirut, Lebanon, and I'm just about to go on to a tour. I want to introduce you to Raja.
Hi, guys.
Let's do it.
So here we have the food team. So they get the data, and depending on the data that we get, we dispatch 100 boxes per day, approximately. We have also a lot of donations. So that's, for example, everything that's cooked here, it's cooked for the volunteers. So here's the first aid team. So what happened is that directly after the bomb, we had a lot of people that were still injured, and in hospitals were overbooked. So people used to come here to patch up their wounds. Now it changed because everyone patch up their wounds, and it's more like
medical
supplies. They can come and check on their families, if they have, like the kids, check if they have something. Here we have sanitary products, so for women, for children, and for the home. And we send them via totters. Every day, approximately 100 boxes.
Mm-hmm.
Here we have Embrace. Embrace is a kind of a line for help, suicidal thoughts, and depression, etc. And of course, like after the explosion, you had a lot of people that lived these moments that are still suffering till today. So they can call the Embrace and talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
Here is the cleaning team. So also the first 2 weeks here we had a huge number of volunteers that used to come to clean up the streets and the homes.
Mm-hmm.
And we have here a bunch of media team, scouting team if you want. So we're still scouting. We send scouts with a Google form. They fill it. And we have all the data that comes into an Excel sheet.
Mm-hmm.
At night, that data is filtered out depending on which operation are we going to do. So food operation have their own data, sanitary, construction,
mm-hmm.
etc. And each operation has its own in-house operation.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Very cool.
Right now, the big chunk of work is the reconstruction.
Yeah. Is that Marum?
That's my
nice.
That's Bush, also co-founder.
Which one?
Bush. You can see it. So reconstruction, we divided. We have the heritage building. We're working directly with someone from, with Patrick. And actually, I called him today and told him, like, we already have 4 buildings. Heritage building, and where we need to set up a strategy.
Yeah.
How we're gonna work. So it's gonna be one team. We have another team that's taking buildings as they are. So we already have 4 buildings. I was at one building now, and we have an everyday operation, which is apartments, individual apartments that need help. And right now we already did 80 to 100 apartments, and it's going to go faster weekly, every week, hopefully.
Awesome.
So that's the base camp.
And how can people get involved if they're here on the ground? Where do they go to volunteer? Me, I'm going to volunteer.
So it depends on how you want to volunteer.
Okay.
You can volunteer maybe with the food boxes.
Okay.
You need to check with the food operation. Let's say you were you had experience in first aid.
Okay.
You could help them there. In construction, if you're an architect or an engineer,
okay.
and you want to help with this, you could.
Okay.
Depends on how you want to help and your specialty.